Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to build a Viking chair, which is also known as a campfire chair or a stargazing chair. But instead of using a typical 2x12, which people often use for these builds, we're going to be using this live edge cedar slab to give it a more interesting look. So without any further ado, let's get started.
All right guys, so the first thing I'm going to do here is cut this board to length. So I'm going to pull down and get a measurement at 88 inches, and I'm going to mark this on both sides of the board where it splits off into two. Now this part is going to serve as the legs of the chair and the seat of the chair as well. And once I get my marks, I'll go ahead and pull out my framing square and get two straight lines that I can then use to cut these to the exact same length. Next, I'll measure down to the center of the board at 44 inches and mark a line. From here, I'll use the circular saw and cut this board in half. Now that I've got my board cut in half, I need it to lay out my notches. Now, most people, when they build these Viking chairs, they'll do a mortise and tenon, but because I wanted to keep the live edge, this really wasn't an option. So what I did is I measured up 12 inches on each board and made a mark. This would make the seat itself 12 inches long and would place the seat 12 inches off the ground. From the 12 inch mark, I measured back 1 3/8 inches to accommodate the thickness of the slab. Now, if you're going to make a Viking chair this way, I recommend making the cutout a bit larger to allow the two pieces to connect more easily, as I had to go back and cut out more material. As far as the depth of the notches go, these boards were approximately 11 inches wide, so I measured over to 5.5 inches and made a mark on both of the previous lines I had drawn. I then connected these marks and completed the layout for my notches. Next, I used a 3/8 drill bit and drilled two holes in the corners of my notch layout. Then I took the jigsaw and cut the two longer lines of the layout first. From here, I put the jigsaw blade into the holes I had drilled and completed the cut. In hindsight, one hole in a single corner would have been sufficient here. With the notches cut out on both parts of the chair, it was time to test fit. And as you can see, I was able to get the chair together, but the fit was a bit tighter than I wanted it to be. I took the boards back to the sawhorses and cut out an additional 1/8 inch from the width of the notches, and this allowed the two pieces to fit together much easier. Now that the chair was fitted properly, it was time to sand. I started off using my orbital sander with 80 grit sandpaper. This was working, but it was time consuming, especially considering how many saw marks there were to try and remove, so I switched things up and tried the belt sander with 60 grit paper. This, however, didn't work much better, and it kept trying to pull the board off the sawhorse, so off camera, I took one of the boards to the planer and ran it through just to save some time. The board with the split in it, however, was too wide for my planer, so I had to finish that one by hand, and this was definitely the longest part of this project. With the chair sanded down, there was really only one thing left to do, and that was to try it out. Now, I decided not to put any kind of finish on this simply because I love the natural look of cedar, and cedar lasts a really long time even out in the elements with no kind of additional protection. Plus, I'm just really bad at preventative maintenance, and so even if I put some kind of finish on it initially, it probably would be the last coat it ever got. So that's it for this video. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Also, if you like this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to the channel. Until next time, take care and God bless.